What's up, everybody? Today we're doing another official Fallout cookbook recipe, the Mole Rat Wonder Meat Dip. So to start us off, we're doing a little bit of prep work. The recipe calls for a half a stick of unsalted butter, so I'm cutting one stick of butter in half. If it sticks to your knife like it did mine, you can do what I did and violently flail the knife around to get the butter off of it. Or you can do it the less exciting way and just take it off with your hand. Now we are peeling the garlic to reveal the cloves. You need 5 cloves for this recipe. I recommend selecting ones that are relatively similar in size. Do not forget to peel the cloves. They do indeed need to be peeled. It's no question. Now put the garlic onto a cutting board, get a large knife and put it flat side down on top of the garlic and use the palm of your hand to hit the knife to pop open the garlic. Repeat that step 4 more times with the other cloves and then mince up your beautiful garlic. You will also need 4 scallions with the white and light green parts chopped, so I am doing that here. Here I'm dumping most of my scallions onto the floor. Now I'm getting out 1 and 2 sausages and putting away the rest, and then removing the casing. There is no beautiful way to do this. According to the recipe, the sausage is roughly chopped, so I am roughly chopping it. Here I am opening not one, but 2 8.5-ounce cans of artichoke hearts. Even though it calls for 2 cans, I recommend 1 because there were a lot, and I recommend cutting them up much smaller because they did not cook down like I thought they would. Now we're measuring out 1/2 cup of grated Parmesan cheese. Then you'll need 1 cup of shredded Fontina cheese. I couldn't find it pre-shredded, so Kyle is shredding it up for me. And then preheat your oven to 375 degrees Fahrenheit.
I am warm.
Well, maybe if you weren't so hot, you would not be so warm.
Is this hot?
Yes.
You like that? Now do the cream cheese dance. Cream cheese. Now, is there anybody in there? There's nobody in the oven, so it's safe to preheat it. You could see it. Oh, I punched an artichoke. I'm gonna go to artichoke jail. Okie dokie, artichokey. Now it's here.
I
feel like if you drop it in a hot pan, it's gonna go. Oh yeah, drop that butter right in there. That's a lot of butter. It's appropriate for mixing. It's appropriate. Look at it. Now take it.
Melt the butter in a large saute pan or skillet on a medium-high heat. Add the garlic and the scallions and cook for 5 minutes until fragrant. Mix in the chopped Italian sausage and cook until no longer pink. Add the artichoke hearts and cook for another 5 minutes until soft. When your friends, family, or viewers ask if you're cooking dog, here's what you say.
Are you cooking dog today?
Yes.
Yes, we are.
Thanks.
No, it's not dog, it's cat. This is the cat who we are using that.
You just harvested some fresh cat.
Yep.
Anyway, now you're going to need to combine the cream cheese, the Parmesan cheese, and the Fontina cheese in a medium bowl until smooth. I recommend mixing it by hand because our mixer kept getting jammed and we had to use a spatula to clean it out. Now mix the sausage mixture into the cheese and make sure to drain out any liquid that's in your pan before adding it. The cookbook also says to mix well. Season to taste with salt and pepper and then place in a 1-quart baking dish. I had to do 2. And then cook for 20 minutes. Here's some trivia while we wait.
Are you not entertained? Anyone know what movie that's from? Anyone? I can give you a hint. The main character's Russell Crowe. If you were thinking Gladiator, you were correct.
Back to what we were doing. Now we are cutting up some crunchy bread to serve it on. We used ciabatta bread.
Surprise! The bread knife made cutting the bread easy.
Oh.
Wow. Subscribe for more content.
Now I'm placing the rack on the top, turning the broiler on, and letting them broil for 2 minutes. 2 minutes was a tad too long, and those are some ugly bowls of dip. Huge fail. Now we're putting our ugly dip onto our crunchy bread, and here is our live reaction to how that went.
Mm. It's really good.
Mm-hmm. I think the only difference going forward is maybe try to cut the artichokes a little smaller, maybe not use all of the artichokes.
But that's what makes up most of the actual dip part.
Yeah, and the cheese. Mm-hmm.
The flavor is delicious.
I like it.
Here's what it looks like up close.
Yeah, it's colored. Same color.
Here's what it looks like in the cookbook. It's a little bit more white, but I think it's the lighting, so pretty close.
If I were to do it again, I would not put it in these dishes. I would put it in a casserole dish.
Yeah.
Don't forget to leave a like, comment, and subscribe, and I'll catch you guys in the next video.
Like, thing. Yeah, kind of like that. Somebody's gonna come into my stream and just see this and be like, what?
I'm dancing on the ceiling. I'm on the head. Raise the roof.
Oh. Hi! Welcome to my stream! This shirt makes my arm look like green beans. Another one bites the dust. Another one bites the dust. And another one gone. And another one gone. Another one bites the dust. Hey, hey, I'm gonna get you too. Another one bites the dust.